What is the cinematic look and how do I get it? Well, that's what we're gonna be talking about today. What's up, everyone? My name is Taylor Lewis and welcome to Film Creator Pro. I have been a filmmaker, cinematographer, content creator, whatever you wanna call it, for about, well, since I was like 12. So like 16 years now. I own a video production company with my two brothers, who have also been making movies since they were kids. So between the three of us, we have like 30 years of experience. We've made commercials for companies like Amazon, Microsoft, and DJI. We've even shot and made our own feature films. Now, I'm not saying that to brag. I'm just trying to get a point across that we probably know what we're talking about when it comes to cinematic images. And if we don't, then we need to rethink our lives. Anyway, one of the biggest questions we get asked by young filmmakers is, how do I make cinematic videos? Or how do I get the cinematic look? If you want the quick and easy answer, here it is. Shoot in 24 frames per second, 60 plus for slow motion, shoot in a wide aspect ratio, use a cool music track, get smooth transitions, have a rocking color grade, and add sound effects. And there you go, your video will be cinematic, right? The truth is, the word cinematic has become kind of a buzzword that a simple search on YouTube will get you a million different ways to achieve this coveted look. But just because you use slow motion, fancy LUTs, and anamorphic lenses doesn't necessarily mean it's actually cinematic. It just means it has elements of it. And if you want me to be honest, sometimes using every single one of those elements ends up hurting your video rather than helping it. But first, before you stop watching this video and go watch someone else, let me explain. Since the dawn of time, people have struggled to define the word cinematic, filmmakers and audiences alike. And the dictionary doesn't do too much to help this department either. Relating to motion pictures, having qualities, characteristics of motion pictures.
That doesn't even make sense. That's not even a sentence.
I mean, really, that's like the worst definition ever. Anyway, I recently saw a video by Cook Optics, which I will link below, where they filmed a dozen cinematographers attempting to describe what a cinematic image is. The answers range from vague.
Cinematic image to me is something that's not contrived, something that is subtle, something that's been thought through.
To incredibly specific stylistically.
I would say a cinematic look is a look that doesn't stick to reality. It's a sculpted image with deep blacks and a high contrast.
To technical, where a camera operator said,
I think for me, lighting is probably everything. Lighting is more important than probably almost anything else because you can do so much with it.
Even with all those different points of views, it usually came back to this point. Cinematic images are always rooted in and motivated by story. What I'm saying is you don't have to shoot in one specific way to make cinematic content. In fact, let's look at two scenes. One is out of a Wes Anderson film and one is out of a Chris Nolan film. Here's the Wes Anderson one.
Excuse me?
Uh-huh.
The police are here. They asked for you.
Tell them I'll be right down.
Okay.
Have you ever been questioned by the authorities?
Yes, on one occasion.
What?
I was arrested and tortured by the rebel militia after the desert uprising.
Right. Well, you know the drill then. Zip it.
Of course.
You never heard the word Van Heutel in your life.
Got it.
Okay, let's go.
Inspector Hank.
By order of the Commissioner of Police of Broca Province, I hereby place you under arrest for the murder of Madame Celine Villeneuve de Goffin Taxis.
I knew there was something fishy. We never got the cause of death. She's been murdered. And you think I did it.
Hey!
Okay, let's watch the next one.
I told you to leave me.
And I told you!
Why
get your ass back here! The difference is one of us was thinking about the mission,
right? Cooper, you were thinking about getting home!
Cooper?
How long for the engine's case?
A minute or two.
Well, we don't have it. Come us on! Fran, co-pilot, you're up. Case, blow the cabin oxygen through the main thrusters. We're gonna spark it.
Roger that.
Locked!
Depressurizing! Engines up!
All right, so which one do you think is, for lack of a better term, a cinematic scene? I would personally argue that they both are. These directors just use different cinematic elements to shoot their movies. Wes Anderson uses the cinematic elements of 24 frames per second, very stylized symmetric shots, and smooth transitions. There are more, but you get the point with those three. The reason Wes Anderson chose those elements is it helped him tell his off-kilter story. Take the symmetric framing style, for example. Although we as humans respond well to and love symmetric things, we still don't see them all that often. So when we see shot after shot, it feels a little off and unnatural, which enhances his weird off-kilter story. Now, Chris Nolan also shoots in 24 frames per second, but he uses wide aspect ratios, dynamic lighting, and a rad color grade. The reason he chose those elements is it helped the audience visually see the dramatic darkness of his story. Just imagine what this video would look like with bright lights. Terribly unappealing, right? But then he takes it one step further by adding a dramatic soundtrack. He tries to make you feel his story with as many senses as possible. To sum it up, what made those scenes or movies great was the story that motivated the images. The bottom line is that the story is way more important to achieving that cinematic look than just using a checkbox style approach with tricks you might have learned on YouTube. These elements might help, but for that real cinematic look, story is king. And each story is film specific. That's why there isn't just one genre of film. There's action, there's comedy, there's romance, there's horror, there's thriller, mystery, western, and tons more. So as one DP said, there are as many definitions for cinematic as there are directors. All right, that's understanding the cinematic look. Let us know in the comments below your own definition of the term cinematic. And if you want to learn more about how to become a filmmaker, head over to filmcreatorpro.com and sign up for our online course, where we teach you how to build and run your own film business. But if you're still unsure, we've also put together a free 30-minute training where we share our secrets on how to capture cinematic images. See what I did there? Clickbait. I mean, not really. It is super informative. Anyway, that's a wrap for this video. See you inside the course.